Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Star Trek Conquest. Just showing a little status report, even though I think it shows you it when you load up the. Yeah, it shows you it anyways. But anyways, last time we got rid of the Romulans.
Infrastructure.
And I think what I'm gonna do from now on is
research report.
I'm gonna do like 2 turns per episode, because that sounds pretty good. So with the awesomeness that is movement, we're gonna go over here and just take care of these planets here, because they're I don't know, they're just sort of there. Might as well do something with them, because yeah. So I'm sure that was in the show, but I can't remember. I haven't actually watched Star Trek in like a while. Like, well, I watched like episodes like once in a while, but not like entire seasons or anything. That's my dog yawning for some reason, even though it's like noontime. Silly dog. You had plenty of sleep. But yeah, I should really get to watching like more Star Trek. Because I've seen every episode at least twice, but I did that like a long time ago, so yeah. Also, I should mention, once this fleet gets like 999 experience points, then you get, I think, 6 moves per turn, which is ridiculous. You can just go like everywhere, like super fast, and it's pretty sweet. One of the things I don't really, not something that I like don't like about the game necessarily, but it's something where I'm just like, why did you not do this? There's a bunch of things in like campaign mode that you can't do in like free play mode, which I think is pretty stupid. And one of those things is the Orion, which they have a bunch of ships, but you can't play as them in like free play mode, which is pretty stupid. I don't really see why they did that, but they did that. Anyways, the farthest we can go now that we've finished those is now we can go over here and we can guard the border, but can't go much further. We have quite a bit of stuff, so I'll do that. Just to get this, you need a starbase to build a ship. And I think we might. No, we'll just have one more. Might as well. And might as well do this, because it feels like it. And, I guess mining colony for here, and, research for here. Yeah, I think right now I have enough research facilities so that, like, almost every single turn I'll be getting, like, a super weapon type thing. So, yeah. Anyways, I've got plenty of ships now. And I hope this guy hasn't, like, upgraded too much, and he has. He has, in fact, upgraded quite a bit. So yeah, that's not good. But hey, I get more experience points, so. Also, I'd like to mention that every species, everyone you play as, all have, like, different super weapons, as well as different things you can, like, upgrade. So, like, in the upgrade screen, there's, like, a bunch of stuff, and there are some things you can't upgrade unless you play as, like, the Klingons or whatever. Let's get rid of small ships. I don't see any, like, medium ships. Medium ships are like medium. I don't know what I'm talking about. There's a weak spot in the shield. Shoot there.
Our shields are down.
And I... it's hard to control sometimes. Shields, everyone. Oh, did I lose a ship? Crap. Yeah, see, what the AI will do is they'll also be aiming for, like, a single ship at one time. So as you can see, most of my ships have pretty much full health. And what they're doing is they're aiming for, like, a single ship to destroy. Which is why one of them blew up when none of them really had, I think you guys know what I'm talking about. They're doing the same thing I'm doing. Taking down one at a time. So, as I'm destroying this, starbase over here, I'd like to... I'd like to do something. It's something a lot of people think is, like, cheap.
This is for Earth.
Like, I don't know. I don't really think so. I think it gives, like, something.
We'll show them. Enemy
joint it gives,
destroyed.
Like, more value to the videos? Maybe? I don't know. Maybe it's just, like, something to talk about. But what some people do is they have, like, this question of the day type thing for their videos, or question of the video, and you guys talk about it in the comments. But a lot of people don't like that because they're like, oh, you're just trying to get people to comment. But really, having, like, doing, like, comment of the day, like, that kind of thing, like, it doesn't, like, get me more views or anything, so... I mean, maybe at some point in YouTube, like, it did, but right now, the only thing that, like, gets you more views and stuff is, did we miss something? Oh, there's one more turret. Yeah, the only thing that gets you more views is, retention time for the video. In other words, the longer... the more minutes you watch, the more popular the person gets. So...
enemy turret destroyed.
Like, it doesn't... it's not, like, cheap anymore. So anyways, my question of video for you guys to answer is, why do you guys like this game? Because I know a lot of people like this game, and I like this game. But the real question is, why do you like this game? Because I don't know why I like this game. I think it's fun, and I don't know why it's fun. So, I don't know, maybe there's just something wrong with me. Also, we didn't lose a ship. I was just being weird, I suppose. I really thought we lost a ship, but we didn't.
For the Confederacy.
But yeah, I don't know, there's lots of...
have been broken.
What did they do?
Cardassia.
Did they do a heal? It looks like they did a heal. Don't you touch my Argus Ray! Don't you touch my Argus Ray! Don't you touch my Argus Ray!
Detecting Cardassian vessels.
Crap.
On approach.
Argus well, Ray. Fog of War is back on. I don't know, maybe it'll make the game more fun to some degree.
Structure report.
Or maybe not. Who knows? Is that gonna fill up now? And huzzah!
Special
and we got an upgrade. We got an upgrade like every turn now. I don't know. There's stuff I could do. Handling would be good.
Improved.
I suppose. We'll do that. Oh boy. We're in a bit of a pickle, because that guy's down there. And if I send this guy over here to, like, defend that area, then, like, this guy will come over here. So do I just, like, take this and, like, move there, or do I, like, stay here? I don't know.
Awaiting orders.
Let's go this way.
Orders received.
This might work out, maybe. And again, we're not gonna just show the starbase exploding, because it's kind of boring. Yeah, explosions are boring. Well, if it's like the same explosion, you know.
We've destroyed the target.
Anyways, that was pretty boring. Now what do they got going on here? I think that's like, but they can't be healing, because healing just goes once. Oh, it's a wormhole, okay. They're gonna try to use a wormhole to get somewhere else. Probably to the Cardassians. Probably. Let's see. Whoop. I think Subspace Disruptor would be good. So what this does is it makes it so people can't go to other places. So if I send this here, they can no longer move into our territory, and that's a good thing. So let's see. I'm gonna just build up my fleet a bit because I got some extra monies lying around. And yeah, now my fleet is pretty good. I get like a ton of dreadnoughts. Oh, and by the way, someone wanted me to look up dreadnought, and I did, and I was right. It was a term that was made apart from Star Wars and Star Trek. So it doesn't really have anything to do with either. So, yeah. And me saying I was right is, well, I was right in terms of me saying it probably has nothing to really do with Star Wars or Star Trek. But I wasn't 100% sure, so was I like half right? I don't know. Anyways, it's kind of hard to see, but there are like little arrows that like are like little indicators, and man, those ships are so weak. I can't even believe it, man.